Hello friends, today I am going to demonstrate on ARM programs, that is ARM assembly program and ARM C program. So before going to start the execution steps, we will look at the syllabus. So as per V2 syllabus, in part A, that is software program, two programs are there, program number 6 and 7, which are software program, whereas program number 6 is ARM assembly program and program number 7 is ARM C program. Now, in ARM assembly program, you have to write program based on like data transfer, arithmetic and logical operations like move, load, add, subtract, and, op, and, or, any, XOR. Based on that, with the help of assembly instruction, you have to use and write the program. In programs in 7, so you have to use your convenient or easiest one or simplest C program you can write and demonstrate the execution. Now, in case of 6 and 7, we have to demonstrate the content, or we have to show the result, which is content of content of resistors. So, which are resistor you are used in your program. So, what the after execution, what are the result, what are the content of each resistor, that we have to demonstrate. But in case of ARM C program, the ID or compiler which automatically allocate the resistor, we have to check the content of resistor after execution, or during debugging we can verify the results also. Then part B, hardware program, that is experiment number 12 and 13, which are hardware program, both are C program, both have to use the C program. Then the 12th program is LCD, have to display word or any sentence according to your convenience. Then stepper motor, you have to rotate the motor to right, to left or to right, or clockwise or anti-clockwise. Okay, now we will move on to the execution steps. So to execute the Kyle base or ARM experiment, so you have to use the Kyle U macro version 4. So after installing, I'll open this application. So it's actually integrated development environment. So it will pop, when it will open up, so at the left side project palette, at the middle one is editor window and bottom one is a build output window. So before we are, to start with the new experiment, so I have to use project, then click on new micro vision project, then you can create folder in any drive. So I created folder in my document, so with the convenient name of MC experiments, that is microcontroller experiment. So I'll give the name as sample 1. You can give any name to your project like experiment number 1, save, or 6 or 7. Then save that. After saving, it'll ask for the target device. Target device is the thing, but on which microcontroller working on it, on which ARM based. Designed by that, which is designed by various manufacturer list, it's shown here. It is ARM analog device, then physical semiconductor, then NXP, then Samsung, various are there. In our lab, we are using the controller name is LPC2148. This is designed by the NXP semiconductor. So click on this LPC21. So at the right side shows a description about the LPC2148. Description like ROM size, RAM size, how many I/O ports are there, how much the clock frequency. Then after choosing this LPC21, then click on OK. So it will ask for copy startup.c to project folder and add file to the project. So if you whether I have to click on S or no. If you are working with the ARM C program, then you have to press yes. If you are working with assembly program, then click no. But keep in mind that when you are working with the C program, you click yes. When you are working with assembly program, click no. So right now I am working on assembly program, so I click no. Then after, at the left side, you can observe that project, it will create one target along with the source group. So in that source group, you have to add your source program. So how to create the source program? For that, you can go to file, click on new, it will at the middle it shows the editor window. So type the your program. ARM is a case sensitive program. So to get familiar with the assembler and assembler directives and instruction. Okay. So and you I'll start writing the program addition of two numbers. So for that you have to write area sample 1 comma code comma read only. Okay. Then en entry. So what is area? So area is assembler directive. It defines the, what the name of your program and whether it is code type or data type. So it is only code type. Then whether you want both read and write. So only I want to read. If it is data type, you can make read write. Then entry nothing indicate the start of your program. So I'll write that move r1 comma 0x05 move r2 comma 0x03. X indicate here hexadecimal number. Then add r3 comma r1 comma. So content of r1 and r2 is added and store result in r3. Then type here b here. So b is indicate here branch instruction. So here is label. So the reason for putting the b here b label. So calling the same label itself. So during debugging the program should not go in infinite loop, because keep on the program counter keep on incrementing. So avoid that one. So keep the to indicate the end of the program. So for that, after B here branch instruction, so I have to put the end. Then after typing your program, I have to save this one. So click on save in the same directory where you have saved your project. You can give the convenient name sample1.as. Yeah. So I have to use the ASM for assembly program. If you are working with C program, you have to write the .c. Then click save. So after clicking, you can observe that the color of text get changed from black color to some are blue, then some are green and some are red, or some are in black. So this indicate the blue color all are assembler directive and instruction, the green color all are register and red color constant values. Okay. Now, so you have to add this your assembly program to your target file. Still it's not added here, because the source group is empty. There is no any source program. To add these, right click on it. Then add existing file to group source group 1. So click on it, it will pop up the window. Then to add assembly program, it's not visible here. Reason for that, it's showing the file type of only C files. So from this click on it and choose assembly source file or ASM source file. Then it shows the ASM source file with the sample1.asm. Click on it. Then click on add. Then click close. Then you can observe that the sample1.asm file is added to your target device. Okay. Now next work is to compile. Here nothing but compile. Instead of calling it as compile, here call it as build target. Nothing but convert your assembly program to object program and along with it show any syntax error. So for to build that, you can go to project, click on build target. Now you can observe that bottom window, the building output, it will show some errors, then warning messages. Now it's showing two errors, that unknown opcode, sample one, expecting opcode, that is comma, label found which has no area. You can double click on it. It will appear the blue color arrow or here. The here also second line. So reason for this error is indentation. Indentation nothing but the program should differentiate between the labels and your instruction and assembler directives. To have to keep the indentation. So to keep indentation, you can put the at the first line I'll put on tab, then second line I'll put tab, also put tab here at the seventh line also. Okay. So here the entry and here these two are lab, sorry, these two are labels, and rest all your assembly directives and instructions. So you need to differentiate that. Labels should be kept at extreme left side, and whatever the assembly directives and instructions should be kept at the right side. Nothing but we keep one tab space between from the left margin. Then after putting the indentation, then save it. Save. Again go to project. Again build target. I can observe that there is no errors, but warnings are exist. So what the warning is? The warning at line number 3rd and 4th, that hash not used before constant expression. If you are using any constant value, you should add hash here. Hash. Hash. Again save your program. Again go to project. Again build target. Now I remove all errors and warnings. Now next work is to, after removing all error and warnings, next work is you have to debug this one. To debug this one, we'll watch the next video. Okay, thank you.